ओके, हैप्पी मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी मॉड्यूल 3 इन एसईडी डोमेन. ओके, द मॉड्यूल 3 इज एंटिटी रिलेशनशिप मॉडल. आई थिंक मेनी ऑफ यू हैव स्टडीड ईआर मॉडल, इजंट इट? फॉर डेवलपिंग प्रोजेक्ट वी यूज दिस ईआर मॉडल एंड ईआर डायग्राम. ओके, इन एनिटी रिलेशनशिप मॉडल वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट डिजाइन इश्यूज, मैपिंग कंस्ट्रेंट्स एंड ER diagram. So what are the ER diagrams, right? These are the outlines what we are going to see in our class. Basic concepts of ER diagram: design issues, mapping constraints, keys, ER diagram and the weak entity sets, right? So what is ER model? What is the expansion for ER? E and R stands for what, ma?
Entity relationship.
Very good. ER model stands for an entity relationship model. Okay, this is a high level data model. What is the main use of this model? Means to represent the data. Okay, to represent the data in a pictorial format and also to represent the relation between the data. Okay, we can use the tables. The tables data can be represented by in the pictorial format using this ER model. So ER model is a high level data model. Okay, this model is used to define the data element and relationship of the specified system. Okay, so this ER model can also develop a conceptual design of the database. So what is data? What is in data?
Collection of information, ma'am.
No. Collection of data is called as information. So what is data? Collection of data is called as information, right? So what is data? Is an object, thing or person, likewise. Okay. Anything or person or object is called as a data. Collection of data is called as informations. Okay, the collection of informations are stored in the form of database, right? So to develop a conceptual design of the database, we are using this ER model. Okay, this model is very very simple to use and easy to view. Okay, we can easily design the ER model, and also we can it will be very easy to view the data and the relationship in a single format. Nama table la paakradha vida pathina pictorial paathama namak easy ah vandu purinjukku. Okay va? So it also develops a very simple and it is easy to design view of the data. Nam data paathave vandu purinjikalam indha data vandu indha table kaana content indha idukana this is represent panna easy ah vandu nam purinjikalam. Okay, in ER modeling the database structure is portrayed as diagram. ER model appadina pathinga table kuri data vandu nama pictorial ah diagrammatic ah represent pandrada vandu we call it as ER diagram or entity relationship diagram. Okay ma, see the example. Student, for if we are taking student database, means the student database may consist of student ID, student name, address, age. Okay, so these four are the attributes of the entity student. Okay, so you see here, to design a school database, in this database the students will be an entity. The student is an entity in which it consists of, in this picture it consists of four attributes: student ID, that is the register number, name, address and age. Okay, so the address can be another entity. Address can also act as an another entity, and which can be consist of street name, pin code, etc. Similarly, name can be an entity. Okay, name itself can act as an entity. It can consist of first name, middle name, last name. Okay, so this is the example for the ER model. It consists of, ER model consists of entity. Okay, this entity is represented by rectangle. Okay, and then it consists of many attributes. Attributes are given in ellipse, or we can call it as ellipse or eclipse shape. And these attributes and entity are related to other using. This is the example for ER model. Next, we'll see about the component of ER diagram. So, what are the component represented in the ER model or ER diagram? The main component are we have seen the picture, no? Previous example, the same thing: entity, attribute, and relation. For entity, we use rectangle shape. For attribute, we use ellipse or eclipse. We say it as that oval shape. Okay, and then relation we can represent by using the lines. So in the entity there are also called as weak entity. Okay, weak entity. In attribute there are four different types. They are key attributes, composite attributes, multi-valued attributes, and derived attributes. We will see in detail in the coming slides. Next, relation. There are four different types of relations available: one to one, one to many, many to one, and many to many. So let us see about the entity. So what is an entity? Entity may be an object, class, person, or place. Okay, it can be any data. It can be either object or a class or a person or a place. Any data is called as an entity. Okay, in the ER diagram, an entity can be represented as rectangle. It is represented using the rectangle shape. Okay, so in an organization, there is a manager, product, employee, department. Okay, these can be an, each one can act as a entity, because you see manager, there will be different types of managers available. Under him there will be so many process done. Similarly, product, the company can produce so many products. Okay, employees, there will be number of employees in an organization, and the data of the employees are stored in a particular table. Department, there can be various departments available in the organization, and the details of the department will be stored as a separate table. So each and everything can be a separate table, okay, or separate data which consists of many details about the particular data. Okay, for example, let us see here. You see here employee. Okay, employee works for the department. So here employee is also an entity, and department is also an entity. So works for is the relation, what they are doing, what work, what is the purpose. Okay, so employee works for the department. Okay, this is the example for entity. Do you have any doubt regarding this? So entity, no, is an entity appadina or object alladhu or class or person or or profession eduva vena irukalam, okay va, and the particular thing vandu describe pandrathu nariya attributes irukku, nariya fields irukku nu solrom illaya, adha vandu we called as attributes. Okay, so let us see about weak entity. So what is called as weak entity means an entity that depends on another entity is called as weak entity. Okay, an entity that depends on the another entity is called as weak entity. It does not contain any key attribute of its own. Okay, there will not be any key attributes of its own, and it is represented by double rectangle. Okay, this is represented by double rectangle. You see in the bank, okay, let us have an example for bank. There loan is an entity. Okay, loan is an entity, and there is also another entity called installment. Okay, installment will be paid monthly or quarterly or half yearly or annual. Okay, so depending on this installment only the loan will be processed, isn't it? So this loan is called as a normal entity, and this installment is called as weak entity. Okay, then entity that depends on another entity is called as weak entity. This installment is the weak entity in this example. Next, let's see about the attributes. So what is the attributes in the table? For example, in the table let us consider so many fields are there, no? Those fields are called as attributes. Okay, in the table the fields available are called as attributes. You see here the attribute is used to describe the property of an entity. Okay, it is used to describe the property of the entity. Eclipse or overshape is used for representing the attribute. Okay, attribute is represented using the eclipse or ellipse shape. You see here, student is an entity in which student pathinga appadina nam enna kudukalam name, register number, age, phone number, email id, address number, nam nariya fields kudupo illaya nariya data sum vaangi vechadha nam vandu further ah vandu contact pannadhu easy ah irukum andha informations ellam dhaan vandu we called as attributes. Nam table ah vekkum bodhu pathinga appadina over field ah veppo, okay va, student name, register number, email id, nam vandu over field ah veppo illaya andha field ellam dhaan vandu nam enna solrom appadina attributes. Okay, or student describe pandrathu nam enna features use pandromo adellanda we called as attributes. Are you clear? The attribute is used to describe the property of an entity. We are using the shape, enna shape use panna pathina oval shape, it is also called as eclipse shape. Okay, this is the example for attribute. Next let us see about the key attribute. I told that there are four different attributes available, isn't it? They are, first one is key attribute. This key attribute is used to represent the main characteristics of the entity. Okay, the main characteristics are represented using this key attributes. It is represented as a primary key. Okay, this main, for example, in the student we use register number to identify student, isn't it? So it is called as a key attribute or primary key. So the key attribute is represented by an ellipse with the text underlined. Okay, by text. Text underlined. You see here in our example, this ID, student ID, is represented as a key attribute. Next one is composite attribute. So composite attribute means if the attribute consists of so many other attributes, means it is called as composite attributes. Okay, you see here, the attribute that composed of many other attribute is known as composite attribute. We have seen the previous example, student ID, name, age, email ID, likewise, isn't it? So you see here in the name also there will be many attributes such as first name, middle name, and last name. So this is called as composite attributes. This composite attribute is represented by ellipse, and those ellipses are connected with them with another ellipse. You see here, this is the composite attribute which consists of other attributes. Next one is multi-valued attributes. As the name indicates here, this attribute consists of multiple values. Okay, you see here given is the example for phone number. The phone number can be student phone number, mother phone number, father phone number. Likewise, or the student may have two phone numbers, so it can have multiple values. So it is called as multi-valued attribute. Attribute can have more than one value is called as multi-valued attributes. It is represented using the double oval symbol and one phone number. Next one is derived attribute. An attribute that can be derived from other attribute is known as derived attribute. Are you clear? Attribute that can be derived from other attribute is known as derived attribute. So it can be represented by dashed ellipse. It can be represented by dashed ellipse. You see a person's age. So derived class, are you clear? I think so. An attribute that can be derived from other attribute is known as derived attribute. Okay, so it can be represented by dashed ellipse. See, you see in the example here, it is a derived attribute because the age will be calculated based on the date of birth. So age is given as a daughter. Okay, that is dashed ellipse. Are you clear about this derived attribute?
Yeah, ma'am.
Relationship. So what is relationship? Why there is a need for relationship? Come on, anyone can tell what is the need for relationship? The same data can be used multiple times, so at that time we can easily get the data instead of getting every time, we can easily get the data from other tables. So we need the relationship. Okay, so the relationship is used to describe the relation between the entities. Okay, relation between the entities. You see here, teacher is one of the table and student is another table. So the teacher teaches the student. So this is the relation between the teacher and the student. It can be represented by diamond or rhombus symbol. Okay, it is represented by diamond or rhombus symbol. This is the example you see here. Teacher teaches the student. Next, there are different types of relationship. There are these four types we have seen, no? One to one, one to many, then many to one, and many to many. Now we are going to see about one to one relationship. So one to one means the left side there will be one person, and in the right side also there will be only one person. That is called as one to one relationship. Okay, when only one instance of entity is associated with relationship, then it is known as one to one relationship. Okay, for example, a female marry to one male, and a male can marry to one female. That is one to one relationship. Example for one to one relationship. Next one is one to many relationship. Okay, when only invention. That is the example for one to many relationship. Okay, next let us see about the many to one. The left hand side there should be many student, okay, many members. On the right hand side there will be only one. That is called as many to one. When more than one instant of the entity on the left and only one instant of entity on the right associated with the relationship, then it is known as many to one relationship. For example, student enrolls for only one course. Okay, students enroll for only one course, but a course can have many students. That is example for many to one. Student enrolled for only one course, but a course can have many students. That is example for many to one. Next one is many to many relationship. Many to many means in the left hand side also there is many instances. And also in the right hand side also there will be many instance. That is example for many to many. When more than one instance of entity on the left and more than one instance of entity on the right associated with relationship, then it is called as many to many. Okay, you see here example, employee can assign by many project, and a project can have many employees. This is example for many to many relationship. You need not have same example, ma. You can choose any of the example. It's just an instance I'm giving. Okay, you can choose any of the example. Based on this, there will be so many other questions. Okay, concept. You just learn the concept alone here, right? Next one, let us see study about the notations. So, what are the notations of ER diagram? So, we have studied that there are four relationships available and four attributes available, isn't it? And the relationship is given by the diamond symbol, isn't it? It is also called as rhombus symbol. So let us see how it is represented. So database can be represented using the notations. Okay, can be represented using the notations, that is the symbols. Okay, in ER diagram, many notations are used to express the cardinality. Okay, what is meant by cardinality? What is cardinality? Can anyone say? Cardinality. Just read in the come on, tell me what is cardinality? Five elements, but the cardinality is five. Okay, if the set consists of 25 elements, means then cardinality will be 25. That means the number of elements present. Okay, that is called as cardinality. So here in a diagram, many notations are used to express the cardinality. You see the see the things. 1 to 1 means we are representing using a single line. Okay, a single line we can represent 1 to 1 relation. If the relation is 1 to many means, then we have to represent in the many place. You see in the right side, there will be 3 openings and also 1 strikeout. Okay, many is represented using this thing. Many means we have to give 3 things. Then 1 or more means we have to give 3, that is many. And also for a single we have to give dash. Next to 1 and only means we have to give double. In the single line we have to give double small lines. 0 or 1 means you have to give 0, 1. And 0 or many means for many we have to represent 3 lines, then 0, then the straight line. Okay, these are the notations for ER diagram. You see the example given here. Okay, the example is given here. You see, company, the company has so many employees. Okay, what is the relation there? In the company, many employees are working. Okay, and each employee are assigned some project. It is given here. It is given in the notations. Right?